That was a lot of leaves.
Yeah.
Let's go eat.
Good idea. Oh, whoa!
That huge gust came out of nowhere.
How come wind is so powerful? You can't even see it.
Bad breath is invisible too, but it's pretty powerful.
Oh, gross.
Our breath and the wind are made up of the same thing. Air molecules invisibly floating in space. That's what gives wind its mass or substance.
And when it's windy, all those molecules are moving?
Like a herd. Sometimes they float gently in a breeze, and other times, like in a hurricane, they're blasted along at hundreds of miles an hour.
But what makes the wind strong or weak?
Everything from a breeze to a hurricane blast is caused by air pressure. That's the force with which air molecules push against us and everything around us. When the air pressure changes, so does the strength of the wind.
What makes air pressure change?
The height above sea level, the temperature, and the amount of water vapor in the air. Those three things make air more or less dense. When air gets colder and closer to sea level, it gets denser. That means the air molecules are closer together, so there's more air pressure.
So when air gets warmer and higher, there's less air pressure?
Right. The air molecules are farther apart, or less dense.
Hey, it's like the leaves we picked up. When they're together, they're heavy and hard to lift. But scattered around, they're lighter.
Yeah. So it makes sense that dense air sinks and less dense air rises. The pattern of rising and falling air is called a convection cell.
Convection cell?
Check it out. Say we're at the beach. In a convection cell, the air over the sea cools and sinks. That's a downdraft. At the same time, the air over the land gets warmer and rises. That's an updraft. The cool, high-pressure air moves towards the land and heats up, replacing the warm air. And the warm, low-pressure air moves out to sea and cools, replacing the cool air. The movements of the air cause wind. All this air movement is affected by one more thing.
Lay it on me.
The Earth's rotation. As the Earth spins, it pulls the wind and makes it travel on a slightly curved path, from west to east, or east to west. It's called the Coriolis effect. Anyways, there are all kind of winds. They even have names.
Yeah, like a breeze and a gust and...
Well, no. Like polar easterlies, prevailing westerlies, and trade winds. Polar easterlies are winds that come in from the poles and blow east to west. Prevailing westerlies are warmer winds blowing in the middle latitudes, and trade winds are near the equator.
So that gust of wind that blew through and ruined our hard work, was that a prevailing westerly since we live in the middle latitudes?
It probably was.
You know, this wind thing is pretty fierce. I never realized wind was caused by changes in air pressure, or that air pressure is affected by three things: temperature, height above sea level, and amount of water vapor in the air. And the convection cell stuff? Hot air rising, cool air sinking. It's wild. But it's not as wild as the Coriolis effect. That's the spinning of the Earth that makes winds curve. Wind is invisible, but so powerful.
Wow, Sam. I'm blown away.
Well, it was quite a whirlwind of information.